Okay, our next question is for Sheikh Ismail Menk. This is about social media. How should we as people of Jannah react when our brothers and sisters in Islam commit bad acts and they go viral in the social media? Is it right to be judgmental?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I'm going to answer you by telling you what I would do and what I have done. If you know how social media works, there is very little that you can actually do about what goes viral and what people put up. They put it up, they're free to put it up. If you block them, for example, sometimes you might not see what they've said, but other people will see it. So I would, if it's something really bad, I would block the person, for example, so that I don't need to see what's happening. And at the same time, I would increase my good work. So if I put a tweet a day, I would put 4 tweets a day, 5 tweets a day, something really good. And you know, we try and flood the social media with that which is brilliant, so it eclipses that which is not. Unfortunately, it's the other way around today, where that what's bad is eclipsing what's good. So if we can, you know, for those of you who might know a little bit about how Twitter works, for example, you have these hashtags that start trending. And sometimes I've been watching how we can, as Muslimin, create a trend by, you know, flooding Twitter with something great. But don't be foolish in the way you say things, because you need to remember it's such a big platform of da'wah, not just for Muslims, but even for non-Muslims and even for the enemies. This afternoon I had an interview with one of the stations, and they were asking me about what's my dream in a nutshell with all this da'wah. And I said, look, that what I would like to achieve, obviously there are so many things, but one very important point that I always think about is those who hate Islam so much, the minimum that I would like to see them getting to is the realization that Islam is not a bad religion. That's all. So if I can do that, and if Allah has used me to do that, we've actually dropped down the enmity of the enemy, which is a big success. And how is that going to happen? By living Islam, by talking Islam, by showing that Islam is actually a beautiful faith. So on social media, there are so many dirty things that go viral, and some of us retweet it and repost it and share it, and it's dirty, it's bad, it's unacceptable. If you take a look at the amount of sharing that goes on of dirty songs of people, and you know, the fashion world and nudity and so much, it is in the millions. To be honest with you, 100,000, 500,000. You look at YouTube, the number 2 million in 3 days, 5 million. And guess how many Muslims are there? It's difficult for us to say, but I'm telling you a big percentage of that will also be Muslimin. Because sometimes you, out of your inquisitive nature, wants to say, okay, let me just see what's going on. So you see, to be honest, you go and look at the bad and you want to look at more bad. Just say astaghfirullah and set it aside, delete it, or perhaps unfollow. Another very interesting point I'd like to raise, and I don't pry on anyone. To be honest with you, I don't even have the time. But sometimes for interest and in order to learn, you see a few Muslims and you say, okay, let's see what type of people these people follow, or these people, you know, like. So now you go back to their Facebook page, a random person on the globe, and do it. See what happens and tell yourself, is this the condition of the Muslim Ummah? When you see, for example, out of the 500 people we're following, those who might give you religious messages are just 2 or 3. The rest of them are Justin Bieber, and someone told me he's a Yemeni. His name is actually Baba'ir. I said, no ways, it's not correct, not at all. And then someone else comes up with some other person, and I don't know the other names. There is a very, very famous woman, Perry, if I'm not mistaken, Katy Perry, that's the name. And the Muslims are the ones who actually, wow, this is good and that's good. Come on, relax. This is going to go down in your book of deeds forever and ever. You'd rather just say, look, unfollow, done. Not because we hate and we this, but it's just because we want to follow a good example. That's it. And don't be shy to say, okay, someone looks at your timeline and they see, okay, there's only people who are calling towards goodness. What's wrong with that? Nothing at all. Don't be shy. So I hope these are just a few guidelines, and I've spoken to you from what I would do myself. Flood it with good so that the bad is eclipsed. Wallahu a'lam.
Wallahu a'lam. Jazakallah khair. We were just discussing with the brothers, Sheikh, that it's a sunnah of Allah that sahih hadith is rarely going viral. It's very rare that sahih hadith actually...
Can I add something? Okay. Today I want to say something that I've never said before in public. When I started some time back, and it was just a coincidence, there's a whole history of why I was on Facebook and how I was on Twitter and so on. I'm not going to get into that. But I used to quote a verse of the Quran, and I used to get people who used to say things. And sometimes you have a verse or a hadith, and sometimes you know, there is 140 characters. You got to get a message through in that many characters on Twitter. So I noticed, wallahi, and Allah is my witness, that there were people who used to swear sometimes the message that comes from the Quran, disagree with it, and they would find fault with it, and they are Muslims. And I felt it so bad. I had nightmares, and I said, no ways, I can't do this. I'd rather it be a verse translated in my own language, so if in my own little wording, so if someone disagrees with it, at least they don't arrive at kufr. Because to disagree with the verse of the Quran, it removes you from the fold of Islam. That's it. If you say, oh, this is wrong, I disagree with it, I can't. I will cry because I was the one who put the verse up. So because I saw this, and because I saw the impact of it, and I said, if they disagree with what I say, perhaps there is something called ta'wil. You know, you might be able to say, okay, this person doesn't know. They did this, they did that. So I'd rather. So this is when I took the verses or the ahadith and translated it into normal, simple English and then pushed it up. That's why I do it this way. People say, why don't you quote the hadith? Why don't you quote? Wallahi, whenever I've put in, sometimes I do put in a hadith, you find that the number of people who are interested in it is very, very, very small. But the minute it's not a hadith, or it is a hadith worded in different language, for example, and you don't say it's a hadith, wow, the world is like, subhanallah, but where did you get it from? Islam. It's actually a Muslim quote. So we do have a sickness, I agree. You know, my wife always tells me, just look at it. You put in a verse of the Quran and check what happens. Nobody's interested. But put a quotation of Albert Einstein and the world goes, wow. So why? Where are we? Why are we shy? Are we shy to acknowledge it's a verse of the Quran? Well, then how are we going to enter Jannah and you walk on the straight path? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us break these barriers.